Architecture is called visual art. It takes a lot of planning, attention to detail, and it's supposed to invoke emotions in people. One person who embodies all of that is Kalpak Bhandari. Kalpak, welcome to the CEO's chair.
Thank you, Siddharth. Thanks for having me here.
Absolutely, Kalpak. So, Kalpak, you head one of the most boutique and well-known architect firms in India. But you're also known to be very picky about the projects that you take on. How do you decide who you want to work with and what projects you want to take on?
We focus on doing a certain level or quality of work. We prefer not to compromise on the philosophies and ideologies we strongly believe in, which makes it essential for us to choose what project we do and with whom we work.
Of course.
So the parameters that we look at when we choose a project is whether we have the creative freedom in working on the project.
Mm-hmm.
If it is a project which we have the kind of typology we've not done earlier, that definitely is something that we would like to do. Also, what's important is whether the client and us have the same line of thought. So compatibility in terms of working with each other is very, very important. We've had times where the project is interesting, but we also feel that we are not the best people to work on it. Also, if a certain project demands a certain skill set, which we are not the best, we associate with them, or we at times even say, okay, here we are, this is not where you will get justice for the project. This is a friend of mine, you could speak with him. So it's not about the money. Commercially, we don't take all decisions commercially. Because in the end, I think the client needs to be happy, we need to be happy, and it's
Absolutely.
The journey that needs to be worthwhile. It's
and,
no.
And you are in the client servicing business, you are in the relationship business,
oh,
and
yes.
You are looking at long-term relationships
yes,
as well.
Yes, yes, yes. I think that's very, very important.
Absolutely. That's really interesting to hear. And you've been involved in architecture, you've been studying architecture for almost 2.5 decades now, probably closer to 3 decades. What is the I probably say the top 2 changes that you've seen in people's mindsets and people's perceptions over the last, let's say from the 90s to the 2000s to the current decade?
So I've had this dialogue with my father
at
some point of time. He says earlier there were very few architects, the number of projects were less.
Okay.
Good architects were even fewer.
Okay.
So, and a client used to come with faith. He was not aware of a lot of things initially. So the architect had to guide him through the process. Today, we are in a very, very competitive era.
Understood.
A lot of clients are very well-read, well-traveled. And there is an overdose of social media and they have access to everything. So a lot of times nowadays, we feel clients come to us with a clutter of thoughts.
Too much information.
Too much information.
Okay.
So now is the time when we have to sit with them, understand what they want, and then guide him through the process to figure out what exactly is that he likes.
Okay.
Of course, at the same time, there are clients who know exactly what they want.
They probably come to you with an Instagram photo. And
it makes it very, very simple for us.
Okay.
Maybe at times the photographs don't do justice to what they really want.
I'm sure.
But it's easier to work with those people.
They say working with family members is always difficult. You joined your father's business and you know, you're currently leading it now in the late 90s, I think.
Yeah.
How easy or how difficult has it been working with your father?
He is an idealist. He's a perfectionist.
Okay.
When I say that, he has a certain way of working. We've had times when the projects are designed, the client has approved, working drawings are done, municipal sanctions are done, and one fine day my father comes and says, okay, Kalpak, I think we need to scrap this.
Wow.
We need to restart because this is the lacuna in our design, and if we change this, I think it would be a better solution. So let's start.
Yep.
So yes, we do agree and disagree on certain things, but as individuals, we do reflect upon a certain thing. And then the next day we are at the table and of course differences, but I think that's a healthy thing.
Correct.
It's a very, very healthy thing.
Of course.
So differences are there today as well.
Okay. So do you by nature have a collaborative approach or a collaborative personality, or is that something that you've had to build up over the years?
Initially, when I was learning, when I was new to the firm, it was all about learning for me.
Of course.
The focus was not about collaboration then.
Okay.
Because I felt unless I'm up to a certain level, I don't think I should.
No, but even collaborate internally between your father and your employees, like you were saying, working together.
Oh, yes. In our office, my father and me, we sit in the studio.
Okay.
My cabin is the least used space in the office. So we work with the team. We are absolutely there. We are accessible. They learn from our interactions. All our phone calls with clients, vendors, they are hearing all of it because a lot of it is learning for them.
I'm sure.
We've had instances where people used to ask me, okay, what is my position in the firm? I say, you are the CEO of the project that you're working on. So
a lot of empowerment is given to...
Earlier it was different, but now I think each one of them are CEOs of the projects that they handle. They are with the project through the whole process, right? From client meetings to designing.
So they own it.
They do. And they understand the responsibility that comes with it.
Got it.
So each one is a CEO.
After you graduated, I think you worked for almost 10 years or 11 years before you decided to go in for your master's. Mm-hmm. You went to a very famous university in London.
Yes.
What prompted or why did you wait so long?
I always wanted to study further, but okay. I was of the firm opinion that I need to get some hands-on knowledge and practical experience before I head out to study further. So I was of the opinion that I should work for 2-3 years at least. But I realized in the process that I was learning so much every day.
Okay.
So I said, okay, while I'm learning this, why do I need to leave this and go learn something else?
Absolutely.
At one point of time, a stage did come when I felt a little stagnated because I could foresee the outcome. Whenever I used to get a project, it had all become a little mechanical for me.
Okay.
And I was getting bored with the way I was thinking, and I kind of knew the outcome of it.
So as an artist, you wanted more?
Yeah, because it's not good to get bored.
True.
It's very important that you enjoy and you explore, because I think the profession demands it.
Correct.
So I felt, since I felt a little stagnated, I said, okay, I need to go out and study further.
Do you have any problems separating your emotions from making business decisions when you have to?
I think I follow my heart to a large extent. I follow my gut feel and my intuitions. At times I've taken decisions which, as I said earlier, were not right if I look at the commercial aspect. But again, if I don't enjoy the journey, it's not good for me, it's not good for the clients. So I do take decisions from the heart.
Do you have a personal design philosophy that you follow? Do you prefer more minimalistic or is it more ostentatious?
Yeah, it is more minimalistic. It is more contemporary for me rather than the ostentatious ones. I feel it's important to be true right from the bones. Adding up layers of decoration and superficial things is something that I avoid doing in my projects.
Okay. And let's talk a little bit about the vision for the future for Kalpak personally as well as VEEKAS Studios.
I don't set 5-year or 10-year goals because we are in a very, very dynamic market.
Absolutely.
Things change rapidly. So I like to take short steps and work to my best. Another thing what I would look for the future is collaborating with a lot of artists, designers, nationally, internationally, because okay. there are projects on the board which I feel would be better handled if one collaborates. So I think the power of collaboration is something that one can't overlook, and I want to experience that and enjoy that process as well. It's good for a project when there are 2-3 creative minds and then you have a healthy debate and
Absolutely.
It adds a fresh perspective.
Very nice. And I think we also talked a little bit offline about you wanting to get into teaching and you wanting to share
yes.
your experiences and knowledge.
Oh yes. My father he's been teaching since 80s.
Wow.
He also feels that I should get into teaching, which I never took very seriously prior to this. But I think now is the time when I would indulge into teaching, because he believes that when you're teaching a batch of 60, you're looking at 60 fresh ideas, new ideas. So more than teaching, it's learning from them.
That's a great perspective.
That's how he looks at it. And of course, I would hope that I get into it soon.
We actually have crafted a small rapid fire round for you.
Okay.
Where you're allowed to answer only in one word.
Okay.
So that's how we're going to wind down the show.
Okay.
You ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay. If not an architect, what would you have become?
I would join the forces, for sure.
Wow. What is probably the most annoying quality that you find in a person?
Not to be able to listen.
Okay.
I think I'm a good listener, but...
You expect others to be a good listener as well.
Or at least don't go on and on where the other person can't express himself.
Got it. What's your favorite structure?
Plenty, actually. Tadao Ando is a great architect. He's done a lot of work in Japan. So I like the clarity and simplicity with which he designs his building, keeping and doing justice to the natural elements. Frank Gehry for the weird things that he does, but most of his work is the most photographed. Whether I like it or believe in it, I don't know, but I definitely give it to him that he makes people look at buildings differently.
Absolutely. When you meet people for the first time, what is the first thing that you notice about them?
Of course, the appearance, yes. But I think to talk to a person is what I believe to gauge a bit more about the person.
Okay. Favorite vacation destination?
I love high altitude trekking.
Okay.
That's something that I have been missing. So I think for me personally, it's the Himalayas and high altitudes.
Kalpak, once again, thank you for taking the time to be on the show.
My pleasure.
We've got a lot of aspiring architects, people that want to get into their own business. We'd love to hear some words of wisdom for them.
I think there are no shortcuts. Please pursue what you think you want to do. Don't get into anything because somebody has told you to get into it. Follow your heart and be at it. Give it time. There are no shortcuts. There are no quick results. You have to be persistent.
Thank you. So we are going to end on the same note that we started. Be persistent, be patient. There are no shortcuts in life. You need to work hard for whatever you want. This has been another exciting episode of the CEO's Chair with Kalpak Bhandari. Thank you all so much for watching.